Hey everybody, welcome back. I'm going to show you three things that you can do in Canva that maybe you don't know about. And at the end, I'm going to share a bonus one too. So stay for that. Now, before we hop into this, if you haven't grabbed my freebie, it's amazing. If I do say so, it's 65 digital products you can create and sell by this weekend. So you can get that freebie along with a bunch of other little things that I put in there inside of my freebie vault. I'm going to put a link below in this video description so you can grab it and start going through that and start creating some amazing digital products. Now, if you're not familiar with Canva yet, Canva is a very free, awesome, amazing design software. You can create, I think, just about anything in the software. You can create podcast covers, thumbnails for your YouTube videos, social media posts, presentations. Man, you name it, you can do it on Canva. And like I said, it's completely free. If you want to check it out, I'm going to put my amazing affiliate link below so you can use that and help me out. That's an awesome way to support creators is using their affiliate links. So I'm going to just put that plug there. Okay. So if we hop into this, I'm going to share, like I said, three things that you might not know. I have an amazing mastermind group and we were just talking about one of these and none of them knew that you could actually record yourself on Canva. So I'm going to show you what that looks like. So number one is to record yourself and record an entire presentation just inside of Canva. You don't need any other movie software, design software, anything like that. It's all right here. So you're going to create your free Canva account, canva.com. You're going to go over here to create a design and you're going to go down here to presentation. And it's going to open up right here. And you can, of course, use one of their amazing templates that they have already created just for you over here. Look at this one. Look how cute that is. So I'm just going to say, sure, let's go ahead and use this template and we're going to start building out our presentation. And inside here, of course, you can create, you can edit the font. You can have it say whatever you want to say. You can click on this font and say, amazing, amazing portfolio. You can change the font type, the size, the color. You have complete control over how you want this presentation to look, right? So we can do this. We can go down here and say, add another page. We can build this presentation however we want. And we can customize it to the colors that we want. If we want to change this background, we can change it to this if we want to. Totally up to us. But the purpose of this is to show you how to record yourself. So once you create your amazing presentation, we are going to go up here to where it says present. We're going to click on that. And it's going to say present and record. And you're going to click that. And it's amazing. You're going to click that and it's going to say present and record. It's going to bring up an additional screen. And it's going to show what it will look like. So if you're familiar with Loom, that's another software that you can use to like record your screen and record what you look like as you're doing your presentation. But it's going to look just like that. You're going to say next. And it's going to bring it up for you. Go to recording studio. It's going to pull up an entire studio just for you so you can start recording. Set up your camera. We're going to say allow, do it. And we're going to say allow our microphone. That's me as I'm recording this for you. Woohoo! So we're going to say start recording and we're going to record the entire presentation. And after we are done with that, after we do our entire amazing presentation, we are going to get a link that we can share. Or we're going to have the option to download our presentation and share it with the world, right? How cool is that? All of that inside of Canva. Number two is something I think is pretty cool. I don't know, the jury's out on if we like AI or not. Do you like it? Let me know in the comments below this video if you like AI. So we are going to go down here to discover apps. And this is one of their new and popular apps that they just released inside of Canva. We're going to click text to image. And so this is AI content. So it's something that you can use. We're going to say use in new design. We're going to click there. And I always like just doing an Instagram post. So we can really scope out what we are making and all of that fun stuff. So here it is, and it's going to walk you through it step by step. It says text to image, and what you can do is you can write anything you want in here, and it's going to create an image based on the words that you say, okay? So if I'm in here, I can say something like, fairy garden, I don't know, we'll just say fairy garden, generate image. And let's see, it's going to give us some options here. And we can use these images in our promo content. So we can use it on social media. Look how cute. We can click on this one. And this is one that AI has generated for us, right? Super cute. So let's do one more and make it a little harder. Let's say flowers growing in a city of candy. I don't know. We're going to do this. We'll see what happens. This one's kind of weird. It's going to be like, what? Like, where did you come up with that? Okay, so here's some of the things that it came up with. And you can get, oh, that's cute. You can get as descriptive as you want when it comes to AI. And if you've never played with AI before, it can be kind of fun. And especially there's another software called ChatGPT, which is wild and crazy. It's super cool. If you haven't played with that, that's really great for like copywriting. If you're wanting to have help writing your social media posts and things like that, it's really neat. So that one's kind of a weird one. AI is probably like, what are you doing? Okay, now the last one I'm going to tell you about is especially for those of you who are digital product creators, or maybe you do print on demand and you want a mock-up for your sales pages. You can actually come in here and Canva has tons of mock-ups already for you to use. So what this could look like is maybe you have created a design in Canva. Why don't we just do this? Let's do it. So maybe you have created a design in Canva and you're wanting to see what it is going to look like on an actual product. So maybe on a mug or something like that. So let's come in here. And all I did, I just went to the Instagram square because we're just going to play with creating some sort of design. And I'm just going to put in, I clicked on elements. I'm going to put in rainbow. This is cute. And we can do something like this. I'll just copy and paste it. Maybe we make, I don't know, some sort of like repeating thing just for kicks. Once we have our pattern, we are going to go over here and we're going to download it. Download. And then we're going to go back to our Canva dashboard, go into smart mockups. And we can click, these are on the pro account, but we can still see what it looks like. So we're going to see what our design looks like on a mug. We're going to say select all of our uploads. No, let's do this one. We're going to upload a new one. We're going to upload our rainbow design here. Here we go. We're going to say select. And then it's going to show us what it looks like on our mug. If you're on the pro version, you're not obviously going to have this grid. This is my like teaching account, I guess you could say. So you can see what it looks, what things look like. So I'm not showing you all of my wild and crazy designs on Canva. We can even check it out on here. We'll say this. And what does this look like? Boom. Kind of cute. So what you can do, we can say adjust image. We can say, you know, if we want to crop it, if we want to make it bigger, whatever we want to do. That's kind of weird. We're going to say save mockup. And then we can use this on our social media. We can, you know, show off what we have created, what it would look like. Like, let's say someone wanted to download or purchase the design that you just made. Which you would put way more effort and this would actually be like your design. But let's say they wanted to buy a design from you. They would be able to visualize what it looks like on an actual mug. So that's super cool. And then you can download right here. You can download that mug so you can see what it looks like. Now, I told you I was going to show you one more bonus thing, a bonus tip that I think is super cool, especially if you're a designer or if you're wanting to just kind of get some ideas for a brand that you're wanting to develop for yourself. So inside of Canva, you're going to go over here to create a design. You're going to type in mood board and you're going to spell it correctly. We're going to say mood board. And and we're going to say mood boards photo collage. And what you're going to see here is, of course, our favorite place over here is our templates. And all of these are different templates that you can use to help you gather ideas for the brand that you are developing. Look how cute this one is. Goodness gracious, look how adorable. So what you can do is you can say, this is your mood board. And these are all of the photos that you have found maybe from Pinterest, or maybe you have them on your computer, and you can upload these photos over here into these different slots. You can decide what colors you want for your brand, what words or what typeface you want for your brand. And it just really helps you when you are thinking of, how do I want to show up on social media? What are the brand colors that I want to use? How do I create a cohesive design? Is to create a mood board like this and help you by seeing it all in one place. You can see the photos that you're drawn to, making sure that you have like a cohesive feel and a cohesive vibe to the brand that you're wanting to build. So I really think that that is something that, you know, anybody could benefit from. I think it's fun. You can also, another thing that you can do is you can use things like this and build out your vision boards. So if that is you, if you like building out vision boards and like setting goals and seeing, you know, your goals in front of your face, you can do that in here by using these mood boards and these templates. So I hope this video was helpful. Let me know in the comments, or let me know in the comments any questions or any videos or tutorials that you'd like to see. And I will see you in the next video. Bye. Thank you.